Welcome to the Culinary Quest by Abtisam. And it's Bakrid. Yes, it's that time of the year where everybody comes together and celebrates it. There's no caste, creed, religion, anything separating this celebration. It's for everyone. And it's all about red meat. It's all about your lovely goat. I'm going to make a very special dish for you. It's called Raan Musallam, the leg roast. It's spicy, it is succulent, it's extremely delicious, and it's such an integral part of our dinner on Bakrid that I had to share it with you guys. Do subscribe to my channel, do like my page, do follow it. Do give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Now let's hit the kitchen and I'll show you how it's done. Before I go ahead and tell you the ingredients, you need to know that there are three different types of ground pastes and masalas that go into the Raan Musallam. So the first one is the whole garam masala spices, the whole spices that we're going to put in it. So I have 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds, I have 2 tablespoons of cumin seeds, around 6 cloves, 6 cardamoms, around 1/2 a teaspoon of black peppercorn, about 7 to 8 red chilies, whole red chilies, a little bit of cinnamon stick because it has a lovely aroma, and a very teeny tiny piece of jayfal, which is also known as nutmeg. So these are the masalas that I'm going to roast and grind them. The other masala that you need to make, the other paste rather that you need to make is, you're going to take 2 onions, around a whole ginger, around 8 cloves of garlic, and about 4 green chilies. Again, green chilies depends on how much you want, because you already have 7 red chilies over here and you have 4 green chilies, so you can adjust that spice level according to your preference. I have a mixture, this is basically a mixture of 6 almonds, 6 cashew nuts, and around 1 tablespoon of coconut. Then I have 1 cup of Hung Yogurt. The reason why I use Hung Yogurt is because it's more rich and it adds a lot of texture to the dish. Then I have around 2 tablespoons of raw papaya paste. You basically remove the skin, the seeds, grind it, and this is what you get. You can use the skin. The skin is more potent actually, but I don't like putting it in my Raan because it gives it a very bitter taste. So I only use the pulp. Then I have salt to taste and around 1/4 cup of clarified butter, that is ghee. I have a beautiful piece of Raan over here and I'm going to begin by marinating it. Let's get rid of the rings and let's get a little dirty. So this is my Raan. I've made a few incisions to make sure that my masalas on both sides mixes well with the Raan. So to this, I'm going to first add the 1 cup of Hung Yogurt. I'm going to add the salt to taste. And I'm going to add the 2 tablespoons of raw papaya pulp. Now I have all these mixtures and I'm going to mix them well, massage it well into the Raan so that it the flavors go in and my Raan becomes tender. That's what basically papaya does. It tenderizes your meat and makes sure that all the masalas, all the yogurt is gone into the Raan. So my Raan is coated in the Hung Yogurt, the papaya and the salt. I'm going to set this aside for at least 30 minutes. In the meantime, I'm going to prepare my onion, garlic and ginger paste as well as my garam masala. So guys, my Raan is marinating, so I'm going to now put these lovely whole spices into my frying pan and roast it. roast it until you can smell the loveliness of all these concoction of these lovely whole spices. It looks lovely, it's so colorful. So we're going to mix this and roast it until we get that lovely aroma of the cloves and of the cinnamon and the coriander seeds. It already smells great. So I'm going to now shift these masalas into the plate and use the traditional silbatta to silbatta basically is the flat pestle and mortar that we use for grinding these masalas, and that's exactly what I'm going to do, and I'm going to show you the process as well. Traditional process of grinding masala is amazing, the best way you can get the flavors out of your spices. So I've mixed the masala along with the Hung yogurt and I've put it in this lovely baking tray. I've lined it up with aluminum foil. Now you can use baking paper, but the reason why I don't use it in Raan especially is because it's a long process, it's a long cooking process, and the baking paper tends to burn, and that's why I sort of avoid it with Raan only. So I've mixed the ground spices along with the Hung yogurt that I had marinated in my Raan, and now I'm going to make the other sets of masalas that go into it before I put it in for baking. Do preheat the oven at 180 degrees Celsius. So before I put my Raan into the oven, I'm going to mix in the onion, ginger, garlic and the chili paste. So this is how it looks. I've ground all the onion and the garlic and the chili paste. This is exactly how it looks. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to, in a frying pan, I'm going to put my clarified butter. Now the reason, usually people don't do this process, but I like doing it because I love my masala getting cooked thoroughly. And this is what it does. Basically, it ensures that all the spices are very beautifully cooked before they go into the oven. So my masala seems to be done, it looks great. But before I add the onion, the garlic and the ginger and the chilies masala to this, I'm going to add my almond, cashew nut and coconut mixture to this. I'll repeat again, these are 6 almonds blanched and chopped and blended with 6 cashew nuts and about 1 tablespoon of coconut. So here we mix this all together. The lovely color, lovely, lovely it looks. It's going to taste as lovely as well. I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to make sure all the masalas are in my Raan. So once I've mixed in my almond, cashew nut and coconut mixture, I'm going to add my onions and my garlic and ginger mixture. Like I said, I'm not going to cook it through completely. I just like roasting it a little bit because I believe that it releases a lot of flavor. So once I've got this lovely paste in it, I'm going to again mix it up well with the Raan. Make sure all the lovely ingredients, all the lovely masalas are deep through into this beautiful, beautiful Raan. So you guys, it looks heavenly, it smells divine. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna lock the foil from all the sides, create a pressure cooker kind of an effect, and we're going to bake this through. So I'm gonna bake this at 180 degrees for 1.5 hours. Do keep checking it, you don't want it to get under or over. So once you've done it for 1.5 hours, do bake it open for about 40 minutes. That enables the fluids to evaporate and the masala to become more dense, more thick. Keep checking please, because these are not timings that are going to be exact the same for everybody. They may vary. Your Raan might get cooked in 1 hour and it might dry off, the masalas might reduce in the open dish maybe within 20 minutes. So you have to keep checking. However, for me, it's 1.5 hours at 180 degrees Celsius and then for 40 minutes open. So guys, my lovely Raan Musallam is ready and this is exactly what you should prepare for dinner on Eid. And let me know how it was, if you tried that is. And I hope you enjoy it and Eid Mubarak.